Good morning, children. Hope you people are doing well. Welcome to today's session, children. In our last session, we have read about an interview of Vengari Mathai taken by NHK Radio. In this session, we will learn how to write an interview. Interview is a major discourse. It comes for 10 marks. So children, you have to be very careful while writing an interview. Let us see the points what you have to keep in your mind while writing an interview. The first point is that you have to write 10 exchanges. Second point, proper introduction. Yes, children, it is very important that you make the person very comfortable, you greet him, you make the atmosphere comfortable and easy for the person to be interviewed. So greeting, you cannot straight away start with your questions. So create a good atmosphere, then you start your interview. Relevant context. Yes, children, your questions should be relevant to the context. If you are taking an interview of a sports person and you are asking a question about the politics, it is inappropriate. So the questions should be relevant to the context. Discourse markers. Discourse markers are very important in writing an interview. They are like, as well as, additionally, for example, in case of, in the same way, otherwise, specially, naturally. So you have to use the discourse markers in writing an interview. It will improve the quality of your writing. Well-formed sentences. Yes, children, this is very, very important. Your sentences should be well-framed. There should be no grammatical errors, and you have to pay attention to the punctuation also. Appropriate language. Yes, sir. Interview is a formal writing. So your language should be very good. You should talk in a very polite and gentle way and put the questions in a very polite manner. Appropriate questions. This is very important, children. You cannot ask the silly questions. What is your age? What is your name? Where you were born? How many children you have? These questions should not be put in an interview. The question should be, who is your inspiration? How did your parents help you? Who supported you? How did you come over the hurdles? What message do you want to give to your audience? So appropriate questions should be asked. Framing question relevance to the responses. See, children, when you are taking an interview, you will be making a list of the question that has to be put to the person to be interviewed. But the first question you have put, the second question you have put, and you will be getting the response differently from that what you have expected. So you have to change your next question. You have to ask the next question depending on the answers he has given to you. You have to change the questions. So framing question relevance to the responses is also very essential for a good interview. Sequence in the interaction. Yes, all the questions that you have prepared should be in a good sequence, starting from your inspiration, support and all. And in the last, what message do you want to give to our audience? And lastly, the proper ending. Yes, you cannot end your interview abruptly, suddenly. You have to thank them for the exclusive interview, for sparing the time and greetings. Then at the end, there should be a greeting also. In the starting also and the end, you have to greet the person well. So I hope, children, you people have understood how to write an interview. Now here we will discuss one example of an interview. Now before writing the interview, you have to write few lines about the person to who is being interviewed. Here we are writing about the taking interview of a Vengari Mathai. So write few lines about 3 to 4 lines about the person. Who is he? Why he is so famous? Okay. Now look at the first slide, children. First part. This is called as the introductory part. It should be like this. Good greetings should be there. Good morning. Nice to meet you. nice to meet you. Got that? Now moving to the body of the interview. Reporter, may I know a few things from you? Sure. Reporter, you are aware of the environment to a large extent. How did it happen? Gradually, I find the people of the rural areas are lacking their minimum needs. From that, I understood the importance of rehabilitating the environment. Here, gradually is the discourse marker, children. Reporter, how are peace and the good environment related to each other? When resources are limited, countries begin to fight for them. So, if the environment is not resourceful, peace will be disturbed. How was the environment when you were young? Mathai, in my youth, the environment was very fresh and full of resources. Reporter, what happened when you started working with women? Mathai, in the beginning, they faced many problems in planting trees, but they become very competitive foresters. Reporter, do you think you have reached your goal? Mathai, I think I have reached my goal to some extent because my countries in the world began thinking of the importance of fresh and resourceful environment. See, children, how they are ending here, you know. Reporter, what is your message to the people? I strongly say that people should participate actively in creating the resourceful environment, which gives us the minimum requirement for life. Coming to the concluding part. Yes, see, children, how they are thanking. Thank you for expressing your views on environment. Welcome. So I hope, children, you people have understood how to write an interview. Now it's time for you to take down your homework. Imagine that you have decided to interview someone concerned with the environment. You may include the following things. Take the help of the hints and write an imaginary interview. Thank you.